meet Miles Krajewski, a senior and student manager for the Yankton Bucs.
We help with basketball practices, running the scoreboard, helping with drills, and getting the balls out, putting the balls away, and making sure the floor is clean for the players don't slip. And on game days, it's making sure we have enough towels, the slip knot, making sure we have the tripod and the iPad for the, and then keeping stats also. And we're there from 3:30 to 8, whenever the freshmen and sophomores start, and then till the end of the varsity game.
So he's more than just, you know, a manager that maybe just fills up waters and things like that. He does great with stats because he understands the game. And you never have to worry about Miles. You know, you never have to worry about things being done, things on the bus, getting off the bus when you get home late at night. He's always at practice on time, ready to go. Things are out.
When it comes to Miles, never question his heart and passion. His story, however, began much differently than most.
We can't imagine our family without Miles. And I can't imagine Miles being any other person than he is right now. We found out during the pregnancy that Miles was going to be born with some type of dwarfism. So getting that news, you know, in the dawn of the internet age, and when he was born, he was perfect. You know, we had a geneticist there at the time, and he confirmed that it was achondroplasia, most common form of dwarfism. So we did a lot of homework and did our research and learned all we could about you know, the condition and how we were gonna have to treat him potentially differently. But all that, you know, was really focused on when he was first born. And it didn't take us long to realize that Miles was special in a different way.
Miles loves sports, and he's played a lot of them in his 18-year life already. But the one that he's best at might surprise you, badminton.
It's probably the sport that I'm best at. So I'm a two-time para Pan Am champion, or I've won two golds in the Pan Am championships for singles, and then three in doubles, and then No golds in mixed doubles, just a few silvers. And then I've won a gold in the para-Pan Am games once, and then, or two golds, one for singles, one for mixed. And then a silver medal in the 2019 para-Pan Am games in singles. Badminton's brought me to Denmark, Switzerland, England, Ireland, Spain, Brazil, Peru, Chile, Colombia, Australia, Japan, Thailand, Canada, and a few more that I can't think of right now.
So when he was, you know, 8, 9 years old, he really started falling in love with it. And first of all, the challenge of finding anybody that played badminton competitively in the area was tough. We discovered a group down in Omaha. That was the first step. He showed that tenacity and that competitiveness, and just wanted to nurture that. And he started watching YouTube videos on technique and learning how to play the sport. And we got to a point where he was being somewhat competitive with some of these kids. And that's when the para-badminton angle started, appearing.
It's fun to compete against them because I get to learn some different ways to compete and how to carry myself on and off the court. And it's just great being around them because they also give me tips and pointers about how to become or get better and stuff. But it's really, over the past few years, they've really helped me to strive to compete with them and win a few matches against them.
Despite all the medals he's already achieved, when it comes to his role models, he looks at his parents.
It means a lot. We knew when he was born he was going to have some challenges in his life, and my wife and I both wanted him to understand that physically he might be different than other kids, but that shouldn't prevent him from doing anything else. And to have him understand that we want the best for him, that means a lot, and it shows how much he's matured as an individual and grown into such an amazing young man.
One thing that I always take away from sports is no matter what the scoreboard is or whatever somebody's saying, that it always comes down to you. Are you going to finish what you're doing, or are you just going to let it go and not push yourself to become or play the best that you can for all four quarters or all three sets or whatever it is you're doing.